Hi guys, welcome back. Simplifying radicals. How can we simplify radicals? Remark, if we have the nth root of x raised to the power m equals x raised to the power m over n. So to write here, if we have here the radical form, how can we write here the exponential form? To write the exponential form, just write the number inside the root x and write here the fraction exponent. It will be the inside number over the outside number. It will be m over n. It's a rule, you must study it. In general, if we have a square root of x, it will be x raised to the power 1 over 2. The inside is 1 and the outside number is 2. It will be 1 over 2. It's fractional exponent. And if we have the cube root, it will be 1x raised to the power 1 over 3. For example, he said he'd write the exponential form. The exponential form of the square root of x cubed. So it will be x raised to the power 3, the inside number, over 2, the outside number. And if we have the square root of x raised to the power negative 2, it will be x raised to the power negative 2 over 2. And negative 2 divided by 2 equals what? Equals negative 1. And we studied before, x raised to the power negative 1 equals what? Equals 1 over x. If we have the square root of x raised to the power negative 4, it will be x raised to the power negative 4, the inside number, divided by the outside is 2. If we have the square root, so the outside number is 2. We will divide here by 2. It will be x raised to the power negative 2. We will get 1 over x squared. But if we have a cube root, write the exponential form. So we will divide here by 3. Just we will write here x squared divided by x over 2 over 3. Sorry, we have here the inside is 2 and the outside is 3. If we have a cube root, just we will divide here by 3 because outside number is 3. The cube root of x raised to the power negative 3, it will be x raised to the power negative 3 divided by what? Yes, divided by 3. It's a fraction exponents. Negative 3 divided by 3 equals what? Equals negative 1. And we studied before, x raised to the power negative 1, it will be 1 over x. For example, the cube root of x raised to the power negative 12. So we will write here x raised to the power negative 12 divided by 3 equals what? Equals negative 4. We can write here x raised to the power negative 4 with positive power, it will be 1 over x raised to the power 4. In general, the nth root of x raised to the power m equals here the nth root of x raised to the power m, and the exponential form, it will be x raised to the power the inside number over the outside number m over n. So you must study this rule. He said, which of the following is equivalent to x raised to the power 2a over b? This is the exponential form. He is asked here about what? About the radical form. So we will choose x raised to the power here 2a, and the outside is b. The outside is b in a, b, and d. But the inside power, it will be the top number here. The top number here is 2a. So where is 2a? We have here 2a. So the correct answer is d. Okay, so this is the radical form of x raised to the power, the exponential here form 2a over b. But how can we simplify radicals? Before simplifying radicals, or how can we simplify radicals, we will remember here the perfect square numbers. We studied before, if we have a number and it's a square root, the square root of 1 equals 1, because 1 times 1 equals 1, or 1 squared equals 1. Square root of 4 equals 2. 2 squared equals 4. To find here the number, just square here 2 times 2 equals 4. Square root of 9 equals 3. It's in order. Square root of 16 equals 4. Square root of 25 is 5. And so on. We can write here. Complete it here. 64 is 8. Because 8 times 8 equals 64. If I ask you about the square root of 81, what number times itself equals 81? It will be 9. And what number times itself equals 100? It will be 10. What's now? And so on. 11, we have here 12, 13, and we have here 14. So you must know, or you must study, this square or perfect square numbers and its square root. It will here help you to how can we simplify radicals. Simplify 2 root of 8 plus root of 12 minus root of 3 minus root of 18 minus root of 2. We have here 2 root of 8 and root 12, and root 18 is not in the simplest form. So we will simplify these terms. 2 root of 8, we can write it as 4 times 2. So root of 4 equals 2, but we have here 2 outside, so it will be 2 times 2, it will be 4 outside times root of 2. Root of 12, we can write 12 as 4 times 3, and root 4 is 2, so we can write it as 2 root 3. Root of 18 equals, we can write 18 as 9 times 2, and root of 9 equals what? 3, so it will be 3 root 2. We can write here the expression again, equals, write the value of each term. And we note here, just we have here root of 2 and root of 2 and root of 2. So we can collect like terms here. We have here negative 3 root of 2 and negative 1 root of 2. We have here negative 4 root of 2. So we can write here 4 root of 2 minus 4 root of 2 plus 2 root of 3. We can write 4 root of 2 minus 4 root of 2 plus 2 root of 3. 4 root of 2 minus 4 root of 2 equals what? Equals 0. So it will be 0 plus 2 root of 3. It will be 2 root 3. Deduction. We can deduce many rules. To simplify the square root, factor the number inside the square root. For example, square root of 50, we write it as 25 times 2, so it will be 5 root of 2. And the square roots are exponential or fractional exponents. We have here root x equals x raised to the power 1/2. By the same way, group roots are fractional exponents. Just we will divide here by 3. For example, cube root of x squared equals x raised to the power 2 over 3. Thank you for watching. See you soon, guys.